Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the yet another video of x86 assembly. In this video, we'll convert C program to its assembly equivalent and we will see changes in registers, modification of stack in both Visual Studio as well as in animation format. So let's get started. So this is my C program. You can download this program using my GitHub account. I'll give the link in the description box below. I have created a new project, C2 Assembly 2. And I have set the project properties as I have described in setting project properties video. I'll give the link of that video in the I button above. This is a C program. First, we are including stdios.file. After that, we'll go to the main. Main is calling function 1. We are in function 1. Then function 1 is calling function 2. We are in function 2. Then function 1 returns with the 2s. It will return to function 1. After that, function 1 will return with the 1s and it will return to the main, and lastly main will return with the A's. For clearer understanding, let's look at our C program in an animation format. First, we are including stdios file. After that, we are directly go to the main. Main is calling function 1. Then we are into the function 1. Function 1 calling function 2. After that, we are into the function 2. Function 2 is returning with the 2s. Function 2 is ending here. Function 1 is returning with the 1s. Function 1 is ending here. After that, we are returned to the main, and main is returning with the 8s, and main ends here. Now we'll build the C program. For this, click on build solution. We have successfully built the program. After that, we'll debug the program. Before that, we'll set a breakpoint here. Then click on debug. Right click here, click on go to disassembly. So this is our generated assembly code. We'll go to our breakpoint. Okay, so the breakpoint is here and this arrow indicates the next instruction to execute. Okay, this is our stack here and these are our registers here. Now for better understanding, I have divided the programs into the different parts. So this is our program. This is our main. This is our function 1 and this is our function 2. Now we'll look at our program's flowchart. This is a main. Main is calling function 1. This is a function 1. Then function 1 is calling function 2. This is our function 2. Then function 2 is returning to the function 1 and function 1 is returning to the main. Okay, so this is our program's flowchart. In this video, we'll only look at the half of the program and other half we'll see in the next video. This is main calling function 1, function 1 calling function 2. Okay, so we will only see this part in this video. So this is our C program, it's assembly code. We are executing from the main. Now main will set its stack frame onto the stack. For this, it will first push value from the EBP to the stack. For that, we'll click on step into. As we can see, the value is pushed onto the stack. After that, ESP will get moved into the EBP. EBP's value has been changed and ESP is now into the EBP. And from this address, it is main stack frame. Next instruction is main is calling function 1. Now to call another function, the next instruction's address will be get pushed onto the stack. So 00401028 will get pushed onto the stack. Click step into. Okay, so it got pushed onto the stack. And now execution has been passed to the function 1. We look at the same thing into the animation format for a better understanding. So we are starting execution from main. EIP is pointing at the push EBP. That means the value from the EBP, that is 0012FFB8, will get pushed onto the stack. Let's execute that instruction. Okay. The next instruction is move ESP into the EBP. So the value pointed by the ESP will move into the EBP. Okay. Now in the C program, main is calling function. Now EIP is pointing at the call function 1. So what happens when one function calls another function? The next instruction's address will be get pushed onto the stack. So 00401028 will get pushed onto the stack, and after that the control will be passed to the function 1. Now we are in function 1. First, function 1 sets its stack frame onto the stack. For that, it will push the value from the EBP onto the stack. EBP contains the stack frame pointer for the main. So it will get pushed onto the stack. The next instruction is we are moving ESP into the EBP. Currently ESP is 0012FF60, that will get moved into the EBP. Let's execute that. Okay. After that, function 1 is calling function 2. For that, next instruction's address, that is 00401018, will be get pushed onto the stack, because when function 2 finishes its execution, it can return to function 1. Okay, let's execute that instruction. Okay, so 00401018 got pushed onto the stack, and we have passed control to the function 2. Let's look at the same thing into the animation format for a better understanding. Main called the function 1. We are starting the execution from function 1 now. First, it will push the EBP onto the stack. EBP is 0012FF68, that is main stack frame pointer. It will get pushed onto the stack. And to set up function 1 stack frame pointer, the value pointed by the ESP will be moved into the EBP. Okay. Now EBP contains 0012FF60, and from this point function 1 stack frame has begun. Next, function 1 is calling function 2. Its assembly code is call function 2. Now to call another function, what we'll do? We will push the next instruction's address onto the stack, that is 00401018, get push onto the stack. And after that, the control will be passed to the function 2. We are executing from function 2. Function 2 first will push function 1 stack frame pointer onto the stack, that is 0012FF60. Let's step into that. It got pushed onto the stack. After that, the value pointed by the ESP will be moved into the EBP. Let's execute that. So ESP moved into the EBP. Now function 2 is returning with the 2s. For that, 2s will be copied into the EAX. Step into that. Now EAX contains 2222, as we can see here. Let's see the same things into the animation format. One called function 2, and we have passed control to the function 2. Function 2 now begins the execution. First, it will push the value from the EBP onto the stack to save the function 1's stack frame pointer. Okay, EBP got pushed onto the stack. Now EIP is pointing at move ESP into the EBP to set the function 2's stack frame onto the stack. Now ESP is pointing at the 0012FF58, that will get moved into the EBP. Let's execute that. Okay, so now EBP contains 0012FF58, and from this point function 2 stack frame has begun. Now function 2 is returning with the 2's. For that, what we'll do, we'll copy the 2s into the EAX. We have moved the 2s into the EAX. So that's it for this video. In this video, we saw main calls function 1, function 1 calls function 2, and function 2 return with the 2. In the next video, we'll see the remaining part. So stay tuned. Thank you.